There was a time when the epoch of ancient Indian history, or rather Indian history, would begin from the time when Aryans immigrated and settled in India. This showed that Indian civilization did not have a major genesis and great importance like the Egyptian, Mesopotamian, and the Chinese civilization. But the Archaeological Survey of India shattered this myth when it unearthed the hidden truths of the Indus Valley civilization. That is the civilization which flourished on the banks of River Indus. With the discovery of Indus Valley civilization, a glorious chapter was added to the golden history of the Indian civilization, making it the history of the greatest civilization known to mankind. After learning about the insights of the Indus Valley civilization, the world got stupefied, wondering that how such a complex civilization like this one, which had all the present-day amenities such as town planning, street lighting, drainage, and existed 4,000 to 5,000 years ago. So let us travel back to the time of this great civilization and learn about its insights. The Indus Valley civilization was discovered in the excavations carried out by the Archaeological Survey of India in 1921. There were many cities which, when amalgamated, formed the Indus Valley civilization. But there are two cities of the Indus Valley which are most famous, and they are the city of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. The magnificent Indus Valley civilization came to light when British engineers John and William Brunton were laying railway line connecting cities of Karachi and Lahore, when they came across a grand quarry due to their need for ballast. That's when the shocking revelation of an ancient city being present there occurred, and hence the ruins of Harappa were discovered. This marvelous discovery was made by Rai Bahadur Dayaram Sahni, which was made on the banks of River Ravi in the West Punjab district of Pakistan. Subsequently, in 1922, Mr. R. D. Banerjee excavated the ruins of the city of Mohenjo-daro in the Larkana district of Sindh in Pakistan. The name Mohenjo-daro is a Sindhi expression meaning Mount of the Dead. These were the greatest discoveries of the Archaeological Survey of India. The extent of Indus Valley civilization stretches from the east of Karachi to the west of Uttar Pradesh and from the north of Afghanistan to the south of Maharashtra. It covered the whole of Sindh, South Punjab, and Balochistan. Governance. The nature of the people of the Indus Valley civilization can be learned from the artifacts found in the excavations. The seals found have no depiction of wars, which means that the people of Indus Valley were peace-loving and did not like to indulge in wars. As far as the governance is concerned, the artifacts point out to the fact that the people of Mohenjo-daro and Harappa governed themselves in a participative form of monarchy. The discoveries of large halls imply to the possibility that these halls may be used to hold council meetings. Such evidences prove that the Indus Valley cities were the earliest self-governing communities, which were not village republics but autonomous city-states. One really wonders at the intellect of the Indus Valley people that the principles which are used in today's times were used by them 5,000 years ago. Social conditions. In the absence of written records, it is difficult to learn the truth about the social life, customs, etiquettes, and social ethics of the Indus Valley people. However, the artifacts found throw considerable light on the diet, dressing habits, use of ornaments, ways of social interaction, and social stratification among the people of Indus Valley civilization. The remains discovered at Mohenjo-daro suggest that the society was divided into four classes, which are learned class, warriors, traders, and artisans, and manual laborers. Just like the Varna system of the Hindu Vedic culture. The learned class consisted of priests, physicians, astrologers, etc. The warriors did the duty of protecting the people. The traders and artisans were weavers, goldsmiths, and many more. Manual laborers were fishermen, leather workers, peasants, etc. The diet of the people consisted of vegetarian and non-vegetarian cuisines and ingredients such as grains, pulses, milk and milk products, fruits, beef, mutton, pork, poultry fish and flesh of animals such as tortoise and turtles. This can be derived from the bones of the above animals which were excavated. The dressing styles were simple and not elaborate. Men wore a shawl-like garment and top and something like a present-day dhoti below. And the women wore clothes slightly similar to those of men. Jewelry was enamored by both men and women. They wore an elaborate variety of ornaments such as necklaces, finger rings, armlets, etc. Ornaments like bangles, bracelets, earrings, nose studs, anklets were generally worn by women. The jewelry was made of different materials such as gold, silver, copper, bronze, shells and various precious stones. The household articles used by the Indus Valley people were simple. They were generally made up of pottery, stone, ivory and metals. The furniture consisted of chairs, stools, reed mats, bed sheets and wooden beds like charpais. If we talk about the ways of social interaction, then we can say that the people of Indus Valley were greatly fond of games and socializing, as the discovery of the Great Bath shows that there existed places where people could meet, interact and have recreation. The discovery of dices implied to the fact that the Indus Valley people did have various modes of amusement. Art and literature. The artifacts depicting the skill of art and craftsmanship of the Indus Valley people are widely possible, as when one speaks about the Indus Valley civilization, the terracotta sculptures and figurines are the first things which come to mind. The sculptures and figurines were made up of different materials such as stone, bronze, clay and terracotta, a material common to the Indus Valley civilization. Majority of the figures made were of females, except the famous stone sculpture of the yogi. There were also various types of seals which were discovered at the various Indus Valley sites, which were further enshrined the artistic seals of the Indus Valley people. It is believed that the seal depicts the Pashupati form of Lord Shiva. Their art was basically inspired by nature and their surroundings were natural. Along with art, the Indus Valley people had great literary skills and had developed their own script. The script is not alphabetic but pictorial in nature, similar to the hieroglyphic script of the Egyptian civilization. The Indus Valley people had a unique style of writing which is called writing in Boustrophedon direction. That is, the first line is written from right to left and the second line is written from left to right. All these artifacts and evidences show the excellence of Indus Valley people. Economic life. The various artifacts discovered show that along with governance art, the people of Indus Valley were also very proficient in trade and commerce and led a very prosperous economic life. The Indus Valley people indulged into various economic activities such as agriculture, cattle rearing, pottery, clay work, spinning of cotton and wool, and trade with kingdoms even beyond the borders of the Asian continent. The articles produced by the various industries were sold in the local markets and traded with traders from other kingdoms. The various remains of spindles and spindle wools suggest that the spinning and cloth weaving was the major industry of the Indus Valley civilization, followed by pottery. Trade to other kingdoms was done from the port of Lothal, which served as a center of foreign trade as it was the only port in the whole of Indus Valley. The evidence of foreign trade can be found in the remains of Indus Valley seals found in the kingdoms of Rajputana, Kathiawar and Chennai, and even to far-flung kingdoms of Persia, Samaria, Egypt and Crete. This is the elaborate history of the economic life and activities of the people of Indus Valley civilization. Religion. The people of the Indus Valley did not follow a definite religion, as the sites do not seem to have any religious relics or buildings such as temples, shrines, altars, etc. However, the people did indulge in idol worship and sacrifices to deities, as number of seals are dedicated to a godlike figures and scenes of sacrifices being made by devotees. The Indus Valley people worship the elements of nature such as fire, water, sun, trees, snakes and animals as seals of deities. In the above forms have been excavated. The major deities found to be were of mother goddess, that is the female symbol of generation, and a male figure doubted to be of Lord Shiva. The people also followed different ways of disposing the dead, namely complete burial, wherein the whole body was buried in a grave with all due ceremonies performed. Fractional burial. The dead body was left for the birds and wild beasts to prey upon. Post-cremation burials. Here, the remains of the dead, such as fragments of the bones, were stored in small vessels, and these were again stored in large wide-mouthed urns. This is the description of the theology of the people of the Indus Valley civilization. Architecture and town planning. As they be, last but not the least, we now come to the aspect for which the Indus Valley civilization is held high regards, which is architecture and town planning. The people of that time have displayed remarkable skills and careful forethought in preparing the layout of the cities. The city of Mohenjo-daro is marked by long-planned well roads, which were amply wide for both vehicles and pedestrians. The road ran north and south with crossroads which cut each other at right angles and ran east and west. These roads divided the city into systematic blocks which consisted of houses. The plan was such that it discouraged encroachments. The architecture is plain, simple and utilitarian and free from artistic excellence and beauty for a simple reason that the Indus Valley region was prone to constant floods, hence plain houses were built. Another greatest architecture marvel is the public baths of Mohenjo-daro. They are nothing but wide swimming pools with various rooms, galleries and veranda around it. It had a continuous flow of fresh water into it and simultaneously outlet of dirty water from it. These great baths are architecture marvels not even thought about in the period estimated before. Generally, burnt bricks of different shapes were used for building houses. Materials like mud, lime and gypsum mortar were used for cementing the bricks. At times, bitumen was used for waterproofing. The roof and the doors were made up of wood. In case of structures being built on hill, stone was used at the base. A parallel height of 2 or 3 feet and upper structures were made up of mud, reed and wood. No bricks were used for the hillside houses in order to reduce the amount of devastations during landslides. The people enjoyed most of the modern civic amenities such as an elaborate drainage system, adequate water supply and street lighting. The city of Mohenjo-daro is believed to have a drainage system which was a unique feature of the Indus Valley civilization. They ran under all main streets and lanes to a depth of 2 feet with loose bricks which could be removed if necessary. The drains had slums and inspection tray at regular intervals, and all drains had manholes which were used for cleaning them. Individual house drains, each with a dump pit, were connected to these drains. The water from these was channelized into a large pit outside the city, which were covered up once they were full and then diverted to another pit. The city of Mohenjo-daro had an excellent water supply, with every big house having a private well of its own, as well as the city having public wells for the general public. The wells for the public were situated between two houses. The wells were either elliptical in shape or had a square coping on top. The people living in the Indus Valley made such perfect water supply system that some of the wells excavated after desilting can be used even today. It has been observed that there were less number of wells in Harappa than compared to Mohenjo-daro. A large number of lampposts were discovered at regular intervals at various sites, which suggests that they were rightly being used for lighting on the streets. Such was the prudential architecture and town planning of the Indus Valley civilization. Decline. Unfortunately, there came a time when the great and magnificent Indus Valley civilization did come to an end and was lost in the tides of time. There are different theories for the decline of the Indus Valley civilization. The theory of Sir John Marshall says that the annihilation to the great civilization was brought upon by invading Aryans. Another theory by E.J. H. McKay and M.R. Sahni suggests that the Indus Valley civilization was destroyed by earthquakes and recurrent odds of the Indus River. A third theory by Dilip K. Chakrabarty says that the people of the valley gradually moved on to the Indo-Gangetic plains and got merged with the Indian culture. In the absence of any contemporary written records, all these theories remain only as speculative. But it is not the end. The quest is still on, and it will be until every small bit and fragment of this mighty civilization is discovered. The pursuit for the truth is still on. Hopefully, not the end.